Okay, here's a question. I'm just doing this one cold. A student asked me, so I think I'll try it. Noon's lock, cooling state, temperature 1, initial temperature from T1, then the body ought to cool, warm to temperature after some length of time. Here's my formula. Cup of Compley with temperature 103 is placed in a freezer with temperature of 0. Okay, so I've got two temperatures there. After 7 minutes, the temperature of the cup. So here I've got a time. So it looks like I've got two temperatures. Probably this one and this one. And I have a time. Oh, and then they say the temperature of the coffee is 50. That's a third temperature. So it's probably got to be this one here. Okay. And it looks like I've got an equation where all I have is a K that I don't know. But then they asked me another question. Okay, so let me write out my formula. So temperature after a given time is equal to temperature 0. What was that? A body with temperature 1 is placed in the surroundings with temperature 0. So this would be the freezer. So temperature of the freezer plus the temperature that the body starts with minus the temperature of the freezer times E to the minus KT. Okay, so after a while it got to be 57.2. So this would be 57.2 equals temperature 0. Oh, that was the surrounding, so that would be 0. Plus, it starts at 103. So 103 minus 0 times e to the minus k, that's a constant probably of cooling, times the time. And it took that 7 minutes. Okay, so now let's rework this formula. So it'd be 57.2 equals 0, I can disregard. 103 minus 0 is just 103. So 103e to the minus k times 7. So it looks like I'm solving for k. Logs are going to be involved. So divide both sides by 103. So 57.2 divided by 103 is equal to e to the negative k times 7. Now let's switch it from exponential form to log form. So it'd be log base e of 57.2 over 103 is equal to negative k times 7. Okay, calculator time. So log base e is the same as ln, right? So I'm just going to hit my ln button. So ln of 57.2 divide 103, go. So that's equal to negative 0.58818 equals negative k times 7. I'll divide both sides by negative 7. So I'll divide that by negative 7 equals, so my k is 0.0844. We'll call that good. So that's my constant of cooling or whatever for this particular case. So now they ask me the second question. Well, let's temperature be 17 minutes after it's placed in the freezer. So I'm using the same initial stuff. It's just that I don't know what the final temperature is. And the time isn't 7 minutes, now it's 17. So I'll use my same formula. I'm going to do it over here on the side in a different color, just so I've got some of my data close. So temperature after a time is equal to temperature 0 plus temperature 1 minus the surroundings, e to the minus k times t. So they're saying, what will the temperature be after 17 minutes? So that's they're looking for this number. And temperature surroundings is 0 plus it's going in at 103, so 103 minus 0 to the negative. Now K, I just figured out 0.084. 0.084, and the time they say is 17 minutes. Okay, so now all I'll have to do is figure that out. So temperature after a given time is equal to, this will be 103 times, oh, I forgot my E here, E to the negative point, I even wrote that down wrong, 084. Negative 0.084 times 7. Be careful with this one when you're putting that in your calculator. You need to put all that in brackets. Okay, so here I go. So second one. So e to the, in brackets, negative 0.084 times 7. No, 17. What am I doing? That's funny. 17 minutes, that's my time. 17 minutes. Oh, I had the 17 there. Okay, times 17. Okay, close my bracket. Go, and then I have to times that by 103. So 24.7, call it. So the time after, I guess that'd be 17 minutes, is equal to 24, call it 0.7. Okay. Now, this same kind of question, you can use the same concept for like carbon decay kind of questions where they give you some information and what you need to do is find that constant of variation or that constant of cooling. So you do that, that's one step, and once you have that, then you use that number, that constant of variation, to help you solve a second question. It's sort of hard because in the initial question, you don't really know. Like all it does is, well, the temperature being 17 minutes, but you can't really tell it's a two-step question. But it helps if you go through the equation, and if you can find everything except for the K, and then you have one other additional piece of information, then you know it's going to be a two-stepper, that you first have to find that K value and then use the K value in the second time. Okay, hopefully that helps.